Dear friends, in this class let us see about downwash. So downwash is nothing but it is an important phenomenon in the aerodynamics, so especially in the case of 3D wings. First we will see how the downwash is created and how this downwash is responsible for creating the induced drag, and how this downwash can be minimized in order to reduce the induced drag. So those things we will see one by one in this lecture. So first of all, we'll see the flow over the aerofoil, how the flow happens and how this pressure and velocities are interrelated. So in the case of 2D aerofoil, the flow happens above and below, or okay, flow structure is something like this. So this is nothing but angle of attack. Angle of attack is the angle between the relative airflow or the airflow direction and the chord line of the this aerofoil. So whenever on the top surface, what happens on the top surface, the flow is accelerated, so velocity increases. So what will happen when the velocity increases? Automatically the pressure will be decreasing. And the bottom surface, this is somewhat decelerated, so means velocity is decreasing somewhat and then pressure will be increasing. So on the this we can easily understand by using the Bernoulli's theorem. So what Bernoulli's theorem says that whenever the velocity increases, our pressure decreases. When this increases, and this will be decreasing, or when this is when this decreases, and this will be increasing. So this is what Bernoulli's theorem says. So what happened? This flow phenomenon or this flow structure, it can correlate to the 3D wings. So in the case of 3D wings, what happened? The flow structures over the wing won't be similar like 2D aerofoil, but this will be somewhat different from the 2D aerofoil. 2D aerofoil flow airflow direction or the streamlines will be something like this. But in the case of 3D wing, the flow streamlines will be something like this. So generally what happens on the top surface, on the top surface it is a negative pressure. The negative pressure is generally less than the atmospheric pressure. So that will be, this will have some kind of inward direction. The flow streamline will be somewhat inward, or it will be curved inwards. And bottom surface streamline will be somewhat curved backwards, or it is moving towards the wingtips. So that is because the bottom surface streamline will have the higher pressure than the atmospheric. That is because of that it is moving towards the wingtip. So because of that reason, what happened whenever this flow comes to the wingtips? So it has to undergo some modifications, because after the wingtips there won't be any flow streamlines, and flow will be is nothing like atmospheric pressure. So whenever it comes to the wingtips, it has to change its orientation. So what happened, the bottom streamline becomes something like this, and the top streamline becomes something like this. So because of this, there is a span-wise flow distribution. The span-wise flow distributions are created. So the span-wise flow distribution will be something like this. So that happened because of the change in the pressure, or pressure difference at the wingtips, especially because of this streamlines, position of the streamlines. Because of that, we are getting the couple at the wingtips, especially at the wingtips. So because of that, what happened over the time, these couples after some time it will be leaving from the wingtips, and this becomes like a vortex. So that is what we call it as wingtip vortex. So this wingtip vortex will be created at both the wingtips. So it is created here, one vortex, and this side wingtip also, there will be another wingtip, another vortex. So this vortex, what happened? It is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction in this wingtip, and in this wingtip it will be rotating in the clockwise. So both are both are coming like this, pushing the flow inside, inwards. It is pushing the flow inwards, and it is in the, this this is inward flow between these two wingtips are pushed downwards because of this wingtip vortex. Since it is pushing downwards, there will be like a downward momentum created. That is because of this lifting wing. So because of that lifting wing, there is a downward momentum created. So that because of that, there will be the flow direction at the wingtips also, especially at the trailing edges, also will be different. So at the trailing edges, the flow is pushed downwards, and because of that, there will be a effective airflow, and that is effective airflow creates the effective angle of attack, different effective angle of attack at the wing, trailing edge than the leading edge. Leading edge will have the angle of attack which is with respect to the flow direction and the call line, but at the trailing edge, since the flow is pushed downwards, and then this will have the different angle of attack. That is what we call it as effective angle of attack. So we will see how that we are achieving. So when the normally when the flow happens, the relief or airflow direction will be something like this, and this is the chord line of the aerofoil. So between these two angles, we call it as angle of attack. So in the normal case of the aerofoil, the lift vector will be normal to this flow directions. So when the flow is pushed downwards due to this wingtip vortex, so that what happened here, there will be a downward momentum. So that because of what happened, the flow direction or flow structures, flow streamlines over the this wing. The 3D wing over the wing, the flow streamline won't be similar like a 2D aerofoil. 2D aerofoil streamline will be different, and 3D wing streamline will be different. 3D wing streamline will be somewhat different from the 2D aerofoil. 2D aerofoil will be, it is following the aerofoil structure and it will be having. But the 3D wing streamline will be somewhat different, and that streamline only somewhat pushed downwards due to this wingtip vortex. So because of that downward pushing, then there will be a downward velocity is created. So the downward velocity we are calling it as downwash. So that is the difference between 2D flow streamline and the 3D flow streamline. That is the height. This is the height that is what we call it as downwash. So the angle which is created due to the 2D streamline or this 3D streamlines are nothing but the downwash angle. So this downwash angle is created because of this downwash velocity. So now because of this, the relative airflow has to shift to new position. So that we call it as effective airflow. Effective airflow is something like this. From this position to this position, it is shifting. So because of that, now what happened, our this angle of attack available, angle of attack available for creating the lift is reduced. So now we are getting only the lesser angle, that is what we call it as effective angle of attack, and this angle is nothing but downwash angle, and this angle will be similar to this angle, because this angle, these are similar triangle, and the similar triangle both side angle will be same, and this angle also we call it as a downwash angle. So now what happened, now the lift vector also has to shift its position. Previously it was normal to this relative airflow. Now this due to the new effective airflow, this lift vector has to tilt back. So because of the tilt back, which is normal to this effective airflow direction, and the lift vector also, the value of the lift also will be decreasing. So because of that, we are getting the lesser lift whenever the downwash and the downwash angle and comes into the pictures. So now in this diagram, we can see that the horizontal component, we call it as drag. So that drag nothing but due to the downwash it comes. So because of that, we call it as induced drag. So because this downwash is induced due to the lifting wing. So because of that, the drag which is associated with the lift, we call it as induced drag. So induced drag mainly because of downwash and downwash angle. So this induced drag we can minimize by reducing the downwash angle or the downwash velocity. If these quantities are reduced, then what will happen? Automatically this induced drag also can be minimized. So how to minimize this induced drag is nothing but if you are overcoming or if you are changing this flow structures, especially at the wingtips, then if you try to minimize this flow structures at the wingtips, then the induced drag can be minimized. So in order to achieve this, we have to provide some modification at both the wingtips. So if you are able to provide that modification, then this generation of the wingtip vortex can be minimized. So but we cannot completely avoid it, or we can minimize the induced drag. So because of that, even in the modern day aircraft, we can see that there used to be a winglets used to be provided at both the wingtips. Because of that, and the induced drag is reduced or minimized. So because of that, we are achieving better results. The lift quantity also will be increased, and downwash angle and downwash will be decreased. So because of that, the induced drag also minimized. So these things we are achieving with the help of some modification at the wingtips. So this is how just the flow condition happens behind the wing, 3D wing, especially in the 3D wing, and how this flow is responsible for creating the downwash and also the downwash angle, and also how the induced drag also produced due to this downwash. So those things we have seen now.